ancient civilization existed in a time known by archaeologists as prehistoric. Moritari was home to a civilization that possessed extremely sophisticated technology. However, that thriving culture was lost during the course of a single night. Without anyone left to inherit it, their fantastic technology vanished as well. Tens of thousands of years have passed since then. The once proud cities of the ancients have crumbled into desolate ruins. Eventually, upon these ancient crumbling ruins, a new civilization was born. Although it paled in comparison to the culture of the ancients, it produced a new technology based upon speed and gears, and gave rise to a thriving population. Within this civilization were adventurers who protected the prehistoric ruins from evildoers and sought to solve the mysteries of the ancients. They were called treasure masters. In one particular kingdom, Canewood's lab was home to many treasure masters. In this laboratory, there was a young boy who sought to become a treasure master. His name was Bolt. One day, he met a small robot called a Tokobot sleeping among the ruins, and his destiny took a sudden and dramatic change of direction.
The Treasure Master, Bolt and the six Tokobots.
Hi there, Bolt. I hear you've been training hard as a reward for all your hard work. I'm going to let you take the Treasure Master preliminary test. The test will be as follows. There is a slate in the Valve Air ruins that supposedly contains prehistoric steel. Your test is to find this slate and bring it back here. This is the preliminary test to become a Treasure Master.
Mr. Kane, what about the Treasure Master test? Don't you think it's still too dangerous for Bolt? Wouldn't it be best to have him continue his training?
No, he'll be You know, Fuel, for someone known as the Demon Teacher among the trainees, you're quite the worst. For these sorts of things, practice makes perfect. Besides, Bolt has a reliable companion in the Toko.
It's true that if he uses the Tokobot, Bolt should have as good a chance as anyone.
Very well then. Bolt, set off at once for the Valve Air Ruin. Once you've arrived, we will give you further instruction. Good luck!
Mind you, I'll be your navigator. Hey now, what's with that face? Now that we've been paired up, let's find lots of treasure.
Be serious now, Ruby. Although you two may be childhood friends, this will be no picnic. This is a prehistoric ruin. You could die if you're careless. Remember your training and be on your guard. Ruby and I will support you from the laboratory. about the Tokobot. You can use many of their abilities when jointed by pressing the square, triangle, or circle button.
Joint is the process of pressing the R1 button in order to connect the Tokobots. Just press the R1 button when you want to join. I'll send you a report too, so take a look when you can.
That's it. That formation is joint. When the Tokobots are linked together by the hands, that's joint. Don't.
I'm sure it'll be tricky at first, but once you learn how to joint, you'll be able to use jointing much more easily.
There's a strange-looking rock there. In the laboratory, we call them magnets. Using the jointing toko attack at places like that will make the Tokobots turn into a ladder you can climb.
The Tokobots will help you climb around. You can also use toko attacks while jumping. If you jump and catch onto a magnet, you can reach higher platforms and cross wider gaps. Those are prehistoric parts. They have lots of historical value, so the kingdom gives out rewards for them. Make sure to collect them if you find some.
Nice. All right.
Is that a pot over there? Sometimes energy or prehistoric parts can be found hidden inside things like...
electric switch. You can press it using a toko stomp. Of course, you can also use a toko attack. But the toko stomp is easier, so you should learn it now. I'll have Ruby send you a report on the toko stomp. To perform this action, join together and press the circle button while jumping.
If you don't have many Tokobots. I wonder why. Maybe it has something to do with the Tokobots control system. I'll send you the report, so be sure to take a look.
That's a prehistoric mechanical robot. That would be a beeper's type. Keepers are reportedly the protectors of the ruins and will attack investigators and robbers alike. It's dangerous to get too close. So use the V formation jointing toko attack to attack them from a distance. Their weak point is on top of their heads. Use a toko stomp or...
Tokobot's help. numbers this time. At time, press the triangle repeatedly to take them all out. Your investigation's progress here. They're devices that were used for transport in the prehistoric. We used them in Canewood's lab to make our own transport. If you make sure to investigate the save point one, you can warp right to the save point from the lab. Try investigating it right away.
Are you that Karakuri user?
What? Who's there? When did they get behind you?
I'm the one asking the questions here. Now hurry up and answer.
Volt, those Karakuri he's talking about are the prehistoric name for your partners. The Tokobots.
Tokobots? What a stupid name. But at least I have my answer. It means you're the one I must defeat. My name is Taji. Let's settle this here and now.
Never seen that tech before. Bolt, don't panic. You'll be fine if you just proceed as usual. Just watch out for that scorpion-like tail when fighting.
kidding me? Don't tell me that's supposed to be an attack.
How can this be? Are the Tokobot's attacks not affecting him?
It seems you cannot use their full power without all eight. I'll just be wasting my time at this rate. Overdrive! Bolt, let's settle this for good once you have all eight Tokobots. Until then.
Are you okay, Bolt? That guy was rather dangerous. That mechanical robot is probably a prehistoric weapon.
Who is this Taji, and why can he control a keeper?
Don't forget, Bolt can use Tokobots. It's far from remarkable that there could be others like him. I'm far more interested in that transformation he used. Maybe the Tokobots can do the same kind of thing. At that distance, you'll never make it to the magnet. If you don't get right up to the cliff edge to jump. As long as you're jointing with the Tokobots, you'll never fall off an edge. Jump to the magnets.
There's a big gear at your feet. Maybe it would respond if the Tokobots... Bolt, there's a big gear at your... Maybe it would respond...
Thank you.
should be able to move this block. With the Tokobot's help. There's something back there.
A morph bot, eh? It's a large model keeper. This could be troublesome. It'll fire lasers from the cannon and its torso at you. Be careful not to get hit.
Thank you.
looks pretty tough. Are you okay, Bolt?
Not too bad. Even if you're facing an enemy for the first time, you should definitely be able to spot any weaknesses. As long as you relax and don't forget that.
The illegal digging team. The desert ruins are full of traps.
Good work, Bolt. How was your first investigation?
Hi there, Bolt. Well done on your preliminary. I'm just glad you seem to get along well with Ruby.
So this is the unknown piece. It appears to have had a number of unusual processes applied to it. It may be too much for this facility to handle. I'll ask the military research lab to analyze it for me.
Thank you very much, Fuel. The other thing we found there was this emblem slate.
You say you found this in the valve air ruin?
That's right. We found it in the innermost part of the ruin.
This looks just like an old that has been passed down for generations in an area called Tampa Rock. Don't you think so, Phil?
Now that you mention it, it does, doesn't it? There are several features that are strikingly similar.
Very well, then. It's decided. Tampa Rock is one of 13 countries that existed during the end of the prehistoric, thanks to a culture that used a mysterious metal that never deteriorated no matter how many years pass. It appears to have been very prosperous at the time.
Yes, the indestructible metal called Infinity. Right now, it's all the remains of a ruin that is barely showing itself, after being almost completely buried in the desert.
The flow of time tries to hide everything. idea to fully investigate it at least once. Your next test is to investigate the Damper Rock. It should be in a desert to the southeast of the Valve Air Ruin. Ruby, please make preparations for departure.
Understood. We will investigate the Damper Rock ruins next. Bolt, make sure to get ready to leave. When you're ready, we'll leave for the ruin from the deployment hatch.
Thank you.
So these tiny slates are connected to the Tokobots. A slate for the Tokobots. I know. What about calling it a super chip?
Ruby! Think up a name later. Right now, we need to find out what this Crane-O-Matic can do. Just what kind of ability it... The analysis team may be able to figure it out. Ruby, send this data to Viola.
Yes, sir.
Controls Karakuri. Do you have the qualifications to control these creatures?
What's wrong, Bolt? Is something there?
These creatures seek a master. They await someone who is qualified.
Hey, who are you talking?
If you are qualified, please demonstrate it to me. Show your power and obtain the qualification. Awaken, Samurai Hover. Confirm whether or not this boy is qualified to control you.
Bolt, we're getting a high energy reading from the front. Something's coming. They provide the Karakuri with a new power.
Thank you.
I heard the story from Fuel. So this is the famous superchip, huh?
Wow.
What amazing complex. We'll need special machinery in order to properly analyze. But we'll need a lot of money to do that. That's it. We can use your reward money. Then we can analyze it right away. You may still be an apprentice, but you've got money, so it's okay. Bolt, when you're ready, come to the analysis room. I'll install the Tokobot's abilities for you. Good work. I'll pay you for the items you collected. Thanks for always bringing back so many items. Here's your reward. Well done. What would you like to analyze? You'd like to analyze this. String slash! The Samurai Hover is an overdrive made for battle. It has wonderful destructive power that cuts enemies in two. You'll need to gather prehistoric energy if you want to be able to use attacks like that overdrive. You can collect energy from robots inside of the ruins.
Installed from the super chip, the Tokobots will combine in a new formation, and you'll supposedly be able to use a more powerful ability. Dr. Viola said that it's almost the same ability that a kid named Taji was using.
According to the report, the Crane-O-Matic is an ability that lets the Tokobots combine into a giant crane-like robot and pick up large objects.
It looks like you can activate the Crane-O-Matic at places that have the Crane-O-Matic mark from the superchip engraved on them.
Thank you.
have to look it up.